Hey everybody, my name is Colin McMahon and I'm the owner of Pittsburgh Comics here in McMurray, Pennsylvania. Today I'm going to be going over the stuff for July 2017, all the exciting stuff that you can expect this month, both at the store and in comics.
From the shining domicile that is Pittsburgh Comics, my old mannered comic shop owner, Colin McMahon, transforms into the world's greatest comic book talking TV host. Join us, true believers, for Comics Now!
I want to start off talking about the big two, Marvel and DC, the big two companies in the comic book industry. July is going to be Marvel month, because we have Spider-Man Homecoming. Lots of really good reviews so far. It's not out yet, but the pre-reviews are all been really, really good. So to jump on that, we're gonna have Spider-Man month here at the store. So it's gonna be double points on all Spider-Man graphic novels all month long. We're doing our book club the last Friday of the month, and that's gonna be Spider-Man Blue, a great story from Tim Sale and Jeff Loeb. This is from a few years back, but it's a nice self-contained story. So we're doing that. And then Marvel has a bunch of stuff coming on. July is going to be a big month as far as information for them. What they have, they're coming out this fall, is a big event they have called Marvel Legacy, which is supposed to, according to them, shatter and change the comic book industry. So we'll see about that. They always like their hyperbole. But they're starting to kind of trickle out some information. So keep your eye on the internet, and I'll be posting stuff about it, about exactly what's going on with Legacy. But you're going to see that name a lot coming up. One big book that they have coming out in July is Astonishing X-Men. The X-Men relaunch has gone really well with their X-Men Blue, X-Men Gold, Weapon X have all done very, very well. And this is a new book by Charles Soule, who is one of their superstars, who is doing Daredevil right now, and he's done a bunch of other things. I think he did the Inhumans versus X-Men storyline. So he's doing a new Astonishing X-Men. It's going to be with a rotating cast of artists. And they're starting off with Jim Chung, and it's just supposed to be their big X book. So that's starting off in July. We also have Spider-Men 2. Spider-Men, the first series, was Brian Michael Bendis writing about the first meeting between Peter Parker and Miles Morales. And at the very end of it, it hinted that there was another Miles Morales in the regular Marvel universe, because the other Miles Morales was from the Ultimate Universe. Well, since the events of Secret Wars, the Ultimate Miles Morales is now in the regular Marvel Universe, and they're all both going to meet this new Miles Morales. So this is one of their big events. Brian Bendis is doing this one with David Marquez. They're also tapping into a story that was their best-selling graphic novel for years, which was Deadpool Kills the Marvel Universe. So to jump on that bandwagon, they're doing Deadpool Kills the Marvel Universe again. So that's one of their big events that's starting up in July. Over at DC, lots of good stuff, lots of great storylines. In Batman, the War of Jokes and Riddles just started, but their big, big thing that's coming up is Batman Metal, which isn't starting until August, but in July we're getting the second of the prequels, which is, we had Forge, and then they were having the casting coming out. And this is where Batman has found a dark multiverse, and we're going to get to see some different types of characters, evil Batman, all sorts of stuff that's going to be going on. The first issue, The Forge, that already came out, actually hinted at a part of something from Crisis on Infinite Earths from back in the mid-80s. So this looks like a real big story, and this is going to be Scott Snyder and Greg Capullo, just the big hit dynamic creative team from the New 52 Batman run. They're getting back together to do this. So there's a lot of excitement. There's foil covers. Just really neat. They're really pulling all the stops on this one. So that's the main news that we have from Marvel in DC. Like I said, keep an eye on the San Diego announcements. We're going to find a lot of stuff coming out that's coming out in the future. So that's going to be fun. Now, instead of going into real big details about everything that's coming out from all the other publishers, I'm just going to give you my top 10 or so. I didn't really count. But it's just the books I want to make sure you know that are coming out. There's no ranking or anything. It's still just kind of grouped by publisher. But these are the books to keep an eye out for. These are ones that I think are going to be interesting. We have Sacred Creatures. This is it's an ancient evil coming to Earth. The neat thing with it is it's Klaus Janson, who for years was the inker for Frank Miller at Daredevil, did Dark Knight Returns. He's writing this one, which I think could be interesting. This is coming out from Image. Generation Gone is a new one from Alice Cote, who is a real big indie guy, and he's been bringing some different things to Image. And this is basically a story of what happens when you're poor, angry, and all of a sudden you get superpowers that you don't want. And so it kind of, you know, definitely doesn't sound like a heroic twist on superpowers. So this one could be a little dark, a little interesting. Also, Mage, the Hero Denied. Mage is a story that started back in the 80s from Matt Wagner, kind of almost a King Arthur type storyline. And it's been a trilogy, and it was always set up as a trilogy. And we've had the first two parts, but I think they've both run before I even opened, and I've been open over 10 years. So we're getting this last part now, finally. So there's definitely some excitement for this book finally coming out. IDW has some cute ones that could be really interesting. There's just a Usagi Yojimbo Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles crossover, and then a ROM Transformers crossover. So they're just having some fun with some of the properties that they have the rights to. Boom, if you're a Power Rangers fan, they have a new one called Go-Go Power Rangers, which is going into their early stories where they first got their costumes or powers, and going to tell early stories of them. War of the Planet of the Apes, they're doing a prequel to the new movie. So if you're a fan of the movies, want to see this movie, come on, I think it's just a four-parter giving you a prequel into the movie. Dynamite has some interesting stuff. There's a Betty Page book. There's a Green Hornet 66 meets the Spirit. And then they're doing one based on the video game Centipede. I don't exactly know how you're going to do a comic with that, but that's my go-to game here at the store when I have a break and want to just kind of run back and play something. So I'm interested in that one. And then the last thing that's coming out is Valiant has a new Faith book, Faith in the Future Force. So they're bringing this out to go along with all their other books, but she's getting another book with her team. So those are the highlights. Those are the things I just really kind of wanted to point out to you. Some previews. As always, I'm always posting what's coming. I'm going to do a lot better job on the website and on social media, giving you previews and hints at things that are coming, things you should be looking for, things that I'm excited for.
Rather than just reading about history, why not see history in action? Perhaps no historical event that took place in Western Pennsylvania has any more importance than the Whiskey Rebellion. Visit the Oliver Miller Homestead on Sunday, July 16th, from 1:30 to 4:30 to learn why this event occurred, its importance in our history, and its outcome. Western Pennsylvania farmers in the late 18th century had little of value to sell back east to be able to purchase their needs. But their whiskey was the best. Monongahela rye became a prized purchase. When the federal government passed a tax on their whiskey, revenue agents came west to impose the writs that demanded the payment of this tax. William Miller, son of Oliver, resisted paying the tax or registering his still in far-off Philadelphia. Not only he, but nearby workers vigorously resisted the paying of the tax and reacted with marches, firing of rifles, and great anger toward the government. The situation escalated into occasional acts of violence and even more angry marches by the rebels. Learn more about these events and their outcome in a series of skits that will begin at 2:30 on the grounds. Admission to this special event is only $2. Learn more about this and our other events at www.olivermillerhomestead.org.
Hi, Bethel Park. Remember me? My name is Jason Planetzer. I was the host of a little show here. You may have seen it. It was called The Jason Planetzer Show.
What would you say your experience at BPTV, how has that had an impact on your life?
I found my voice. I learned how to be funny. I learned how to create things. I learned how to collaborate with people here. I developed an interest in film and comedy and making videos. it stuck with me. It continued through my life. I got into working on motion pictures. I now I'll produce small videos. I'll work with producers on commercials, television projects, feature films. I scout locations on TV shows and movies, which involves me reading scripts, finding the locations that need to be shot, and collaborating with the director and production designer to find the perfect spot. It all started at BPTV for me.
Spoiler alert. Every month now, I'm going to kind of spotlight a book that I think kind of underperformed or people just kind of missed. There was a book that came out last month that I thought was really neat, a really neat idea with two really good creators that didn't really take off the way I expected it to. A book called Crosswind. This is by Gail Simone, just a fan favorite writer, done a ton of Batgirl, Wonder Woman, all sorts of stuff. It's also Cat Staggs did the art, and it really has just, you know, beautiful, really, photorealistic art, but just really nice, really clean. And it's basically the story of a hitman who suddenly body swaps with someone else, and all of a sudden the guy becomes a girl. A dark noir kind of story that just kind of underperformed. And I think this is a book people are going to want to read. I think this was a lot of fun, a really interesting book. So what I'm going to do, if you mention you saw it on the TV show, either, you know, depending on how you watched it, doesn't matter to me. Come on in and I will give you one for free. Okay, so come on in while supplies last. But just mention you saw it on the show and I will happily hand one over to you. So you give it a try, because I really think this needs to get on a lot more people's hands. Interesting book, great creative team, and I think it should do really well. Comic shop news. What's going on here at the store? Well, like I already said, we're doing Spider-Man month, so double points on all Spider-Man books. The book club's the last Friday of the month. We're doing Spider-Man Blue. We're getting the store back together. It seems like every time we plan to fix the flooring, things go wrong, but we're going to get that done. Doing the floor isn't the problem. It's moving all the books and bookshelves off the floor. That's the trying to figure out exactly the best way to do that. That's what's kind of stopping me. Every time we have a plan, it falls apart. Somebody can't make it. So we will get the store back together. I'm also planning on restocking the back issues. We've done a lot of big sales and things to clear out the back issues, and now I just need to get stuff put back in there and get new books in there. So that's my big focus on this summer, is to be restocking that. So if you're looking for something, keep looking. Or ask, and I'll see if I can find it for you. But that's a big focus. Also, because we have so many graphic novels, I need to thin them out a little bit. I need to move out some of the stuff that's not selling as well as other books. So keep an eye on the half-off shelves in the back. I'm going to keep them stocked, keep them fresh, keep the inventory in there moving. So keep an eye there every once in a while. You'll find a gem or something you didn't know you wanted, and they're all going to be, you know, nicely discounted to make them affordable. So that's our show for July. Thanks for watching. As always, you can find me at the store and on the website, pittsburghcomics.com, under Facebook, under Pittsburgh Comics. Instagram and Twitter is just PGH Comics. And stay tuned for Comic Previews Theater. Thanks for watching.
Two moments are common to the life of every psychic. First, the realization, usually in childhood, that the voices echoing, raging, shouting through their heads are other people's thoughts. And the second, when they understand that no one else can hear them. A child blind from birth experiences something similar when they realize that every other living being in the world possesses a sense that they do not sight. A tragedy. Underobserved and profound. A great reassessment of their relationship to the world. But for a psychic, this moment is different. In that instant, they realize one simple thing. Everyone else is blind. To psychics, the world is opened for all the good it does them. There is a weight to the world's thoughts. The more feeble psychics isolate themselves rather than feel it. And that is why, at first, no one noticed that they were dying. In their hermit caves, their desert islands, their boats, dying one by one. But the lonely ones are weak, and after enough failures, it is clear that there will be no success absent stronger meat. Bessie Braddock, Psylocke, as powerful as any psychic on the planet, a good subject.
What?
But of course, attacking Psylocke will not go unnoticed. She has chosen to engage with the world. To help, or hurt, however she can. For all the good it does her, Lucas Bishop, a soldier, his enemy is the future.
I've got the rest of the papers for you, Bishop. The Asian weeklies.
Thank you, Dora.
He is a time traveler. He has seen 1,000 doomed futures, 1,000 poisoned paths. Each begins with a spark, ignored until it erupts into a blaze and eats the world. He knows them all. Every spark.
So, I'll see you tomorrow then?
Yeah, tomorrow.
He spends his days watching, reading, looking for sparks to stamp them out before they grow. He is a soldier, a sentinel against the apocalypse. His war can never be won, and his war can never end. The future always comes. Warren Worthington III, the Angel. He, like Bishop, is shaped by apocalypse. He carries the end of the world inside him, a terrible power always seeking to fulfill its destiny of fire and blood. As long as Angel remains at peace, that power is his to control and use. But who among us is always at peace?
Little luck, eh?
Gambit.
Just one good roll, all I ask, me.
A charming thief. He was born for this.
Bonjour, partner! To my horror, I notice that you do not appear to be carrying anything particularly valuable.
Phantom X, somewhat less charming. Also a thief. He was made for this, in a laboratory. Both thieves could choose another path. They do not.
I couldn't get it. There was a complication. Beaucoup complications. Very complicated.
Perhaps I can make both of your lives less complicated by simply dropping you.
They are their own apocalypse.
How long until we get back stateside, Rogue?
3 hours or so. Why? You got big plans?
Logan, the one who has already met his apocalypse, and he survived, him and him alone. Logan always survives. He is metal and stone. The world breaks against him.
Yeah, I got plans. I'm old as dirt, girl. 3 whole hours? I'm thinking nap. You?
No, Logan. No plans.
And Rogue, even stronger than Logan. But if he is stone, she is water. She changes constantly with everyone she touches.
I know better.
It is a confusing way to live. In her desperation, Psylocke calls out to anyone who can help her. Her butterflies find those who are near. Perhaps not the best X-Men to face the horrors to come, but the ones who are called. And after enough failures, it is clear that there will be no success absent stronger meat.
What? No success absent stronger meat.
So I actually did read that correctly?
Yeah.
Okay.
Want to call Adam?
No.
Two moments are coming. I did everything I could. Of every psychic.
Yes, Aquaman already has a bad enough reputation.
Right.
Now he's a lame.
I thought he'd enjoy it. He was here. I'm like, yeah, hey, let's.
I know. That happens.
I tried.